Hello.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. How are you today?
I am fine, teacher. And you?
I'm excellent. Thank you for asking.
Okay.
Hello, Osmin. Hello. Osmin. Hello, how are you?
Hello, 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 teacher.
I'm fine. Nice. I'm okay. Thank you for asking. Ready for a new day.
Yes, ready now.
Ready now for the class. Excellent. That's the attitude. Es el actitud. That's the attitude. I'm just asking.
Voy a estar este.
Sorry. Se fue. He left. Hello, Mayra.
Good evening.
Good evening. It's good to see you early today. Long time.
Thank you.
Long time no see you early.
Yeah.
We're about to start. So tell me, how was your day? ¿Cómo estuvo el día? How was your day? Was good.
For me, very good, because today I work from home.
Oh, nice. So it was very good then.
Yes.
Working from home with family. I like to work from home. I really like it.
Yeah, me too.
Nice. Hello, Ada.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you doing?
Fine, teacher.
Oh, nice. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Okay. Hello, Darwin.
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. How do you feel today?
With all the power.
Nice, very good. That's the attitude. Es el actitud, that's the attitude. With all the powers.
Yes, nice to see you, teacher, and the partners.
Nice to see you too. Thank you. No time to sleep, Mayra.
No.
Oh my goodness. Is she your daughter?
Yes, it's my daughter.
How old is she?
She is 4 years old.
Nice. When is her birthday?
July 27th.
Oh, okay, so she's four. Exactly 4 months, right? Y algunos meses and some months.
Yes.
Oh, nice. Very good. Hello, Angela.
Hello, teacher.
How was your day? ¿Cómo estuvo el día? How was your day?
My day is has with a lot of work.
With a lot of work. Oh, my God.
Yes,
busy.
Yes.
Busy, you can say. Was busy.
Busy?
Ocupado. Estuvo
yes,
ocupado.
Yes.
He was busy.
Very busy.
Oh my goodness, I imagine. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that.
I like very easy. Estar muy ocupado.
You like to be busy.
Me gusta, sí. Yes.
Oh, nice.
I like it.
You like it. It's better. So you don't, sometimes when we're not busy, we get boring very quickly, right? We get bored. Very quickly, nos aburrimos.
Yes. Al no estar haciendo nada.
When I'm doing nothing, you say. When I'm doing.
When I'm doing nothing.
Nothing.
It's very boring.
Yeah, definitely. It's true.
For me, yes.
I agree.
Okay, yes.
All right, so let's begin, and I will start passing the attendance because we have a lot of activities for today, okay? So let's begin. Ada?
Present.
Adriana? Ana Michelle? Angela?
Present, teacher.
Darwin?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Flor? Gloria. Joana.
Teacher se está, tiene problemas para conectarse, pero ya está en eso.
Ah, ok. Oye. Thank you. Ok, thank you very much.
Present, teacher.
Hello, hello.
Ahora voy a estar de oyente, teacher, porque ahora sí tengo parcial.
Ok.
Pero luego me uno para hacer las actividades.
Please, please. Thank you.
Ok.
Lourdes.
I'm here, teacher.
Very good. Margarita.
I'm here. I'm going to go to home.
Okay, right now.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Mayra.
Present.
Miguel. Nelson.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Ofelia.
Here, teacher. Voy en camino, teacher.
Okay. Osmin.
Present, teacher.
Rafael.
Present.
Rosa.
Present. Good evening.
Good evening. Sandra. Yancy.
Present.
Okay. Zulma.
Dios bendiga. Va bien.
Zulma. Azalia.
Present, good evening.
Good evening. Ingrid. And Susana. Okay. Okay. So let's start. So welcome everybody to today's class. Just a quick reminder, okay? I will do the reminder at the end too, but just a quick reminder. Okay? Just remember that tomorrow is the last day for section number three, okay? Tomorrow is the last day for section number three, okay? Mañana es el último día para la sección tres, así que espero que estén trabajando los ejercicios, okay? I hope everybody is working the exercises. Y como siempre saben de que el día miércoles terminamos sección y ese día deben tener la sección completa. Así que mañana miércoles antes de la sesión, la sección 3 debe estar completa en la plataforma, ¿ok? So please take notes, tomen notas si se les ha olvidado algunos. Take notes if you have forgotten, ¿ok? Anyways, I will do the reminder at the end, ¿ok? I will do the reminder at the end. Ok, again. Okay, no problem. Again, I want to say welcome to this class. For today, we have a very interesting and somehow difficult topic, okay? Because we need some verbs in past participle, not in past, okay? No sé si algunos, la vez pasada que Nelson creo que fue, nos envió una lista de verbos, alguien se ha dedicado el tiempo para estudiar los verbos en pasado.
No, teacher.
Deberían. Deberían, porque si no, el detalle es que van a ir avanzando y no se van a ir aprendiendo los verbos. Y en inglés, aprenderse los verbos es fundamental, es súper importante, ¿ok? Hablo de los verbos irregulares, porque con los regulares no hay mucho problema, ¿verdad? We have not so many problems, porque solo le aplicamos una regla y les ponemos ed. Y ya los tenemos en pasado y en pasado participio. El problema es con los verbos irregulares. Que, por ejemplo, para decir what, olvidar, in present I say forget, pero en pasado no digo forget it con ed, sino que digo forgot con o. Y en pasado participio digo forgotten, ¿ok? Esas tres formas de los verbos las debemos saber porque ahora vamos a estar estudiando la tercera forma. Y si ni siquiera han estudiado la segunda forma, que es la de pasado, nos va a costar más manejar la de pasado participio, ¿ok? Así que la sugerencia para todos es que vayan estudiando verbos. Good evening. Que se pongan una meta. Que se pongan una meta y que empiecen a estudiar los verbos. Porque esto es importante en el idioma. This is very important in the language, ¿ok? No pueden saber el idioma, no pueden aprender el idioma sin saber verbos. ¿Ok? Así que so that's very important. So start checking verbs, please, ¿ok? Le vamos a pedir a Nelson que nos reenvíe la lista otra vez. ¿Ok? Thank you. All right. Okay, so I will give you some verbs today, but the idea is that you know the majority or at least the most common verbs in English, okay? So that's the idea, okay? That you memorize the most common verbs in English, in present, past and past participle, the three forms, okay? And Spanish, of course, right? And the meaning. Okay, so we are going to start then. And to start, we have this activity. Here we have some situations, okay? On page number 28, we have some situations, okay? Oh my goodness. Okay, let me see here. Yeah, I think it's this one. Let me check. Okay, yeah, here. Sorry. So here we have some strategies, okay? So do you remember that yesterday we studied the meaning of overstaffing and understaffing? What is the difference? What is overstaffing, for example? Do you remember what is overstaffing?
Exceso de personal.
Sorry?
Exceso de personal.
Exceso de personal. Overstaffing and understaffing?
Falta de personal.
Falta de personal. So it's like the opposite, right? So overstaffing, exceso de personal. Understaffing, ausencia o poco personal, okay? Falta de personal, okay? Very good. So listen, the question is, which of these strategies, we have six strategies, okay? Which of these strategies do you, okay, consider effective to avoid overstaffing and understaffing, okay? So these are some possible strategies to avoid. What is avoid? ¿Qué era avoid, dijimos?
Evitar.
Evitar, okay? So strategies to avoid overstaffing and understaffing, okay? Para evadir, okay? Para eludir, overstaffing y understaffing. Good. And we have six strategies, okay? So listen, you are going to work in pairs and you are going to choose two strategies. You are going to select three strategies, okay? Two strategies that you consider effective, that you consider effective to avoid overstaffing and understaffing. We have six strategies. So please, in pairs, select two, okay? The ones you consider more effective, las que consideran más efectivas, the ones you consider more effective. And I will give you like 7 minutes, okay, to select. And after that, you will explain why you selected those strategies, okay? Va a explicar por qué seleccionaron esas dos estrategias como las más efectivas, okay? Any question? Any question? It's page number 28, página número 28, page number 28. So do we have any questions? So I repeat, we have six strategies to avoid overstaffing and understaffing. You in pairs need to select two strategies, okay? And you explain why you consider these strategies that you select, okay, are effective to avoid overstaffing and understaffing, okay? That's it. Questions? Is it clear? No, ¿está claro? Is it clear? Yes, right. Yes, right.
Yes.
Okay. So we are going to work in pairs, but let me ask something, okay? Jancy, ¿vas a trabajar en actividad, Jancy?
Yes, teacher.
Ah, ok, sí, porque veo cámaras apagadas. Mejor les hago la consulta primero. Ana Michelle.
Yes.
Yes, ok. Susana. ¿Va a participar en la actividad? Yes.
Yes.
Ok, Rafael.
No, teacher, I can't.
Ok, Osmin.
Sorry.
Nelson is in a meeting. Joanna is... Okay.
Porque estoy en una breve reunión, pero ya voy a incorporarme.
It's fine. It's okay. Lourdes?
Teacher, in this moment, I arrive at home.
Okay.
Can you wait me 5 minutes, please?
All right. Okay. Okay. So let's start working then. So you are going to work in pairs or in groups of three, at least. Okay. So let me make 6 groups. Okay. Let's begin. Possibly I am going to move some people, okay?
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Ya estoy listo. Puedo incorporarme al grupo.
Ok, entre al grupo entonces que fue asignado.
¿Perdón?
Entre al grupo que fue asignado. Ahorita los asigné a grupos de trabajo.
Perfecto. Vamos a ver.
Overstaffing. Ajá. El over es tener más personal de más, ¿verdad?
Ajá, tener personal de más. Que en español no sé cuál sería la traducción literal.
¿Verdad?
Exceso de personal.
Exceso así de personal. Tal cual, exceso de personal.
Yeah, you can say that.
Okay. Bye. La primera opción es provide the schedule to your employees quickly. Que yo lo traduzco como dar a los empleados un cronograma rápido. Calendario rápido. El segundo dice find a method to communicate quickly with employees. Encontrar un método de comunicación rápido con los empleados. El tercero, take working preference into account.
Esa no la entiendo.
Ajá, ni yo.
Toma. Tener.
Como tener preferencias de trabajo en las cuentas.
Which one?
Number three.
Es como tener preferencias de trabajo en cuenta. O tomar. I would say tomar.
Tomar. Pero ahí a qué hace referencia, teacher.
Sorry.
¿A qué hace referencia a ese punto? ¿O cómo se podría traducir?
Yeah, I would say tomar, well, the translation would be tomar preferencias de trabajo en cuenta. Uh-huh, it's like to have preferences for people. That's the intention of the sentence. Remember that possibly some of the sentences are not they don't match the effectiveness for to avoid overstaffing or understaffing. So what you need is to select two, right? Two that you consider important. Possibly some are not important. Okay?
Okay.
The fourth is schedule having your employees' strengths in mind. Como tener organizado.
I would say, I would say that I'm just trying to understand number three. I think the intention is like, for example, to take into account the preferences that the employees have for a specific work. That's the idea, okay? Tomar en cuenta las preferencias que los empleados tienen para algún trabajo específico, tareas específicas. So that's the idea, I think. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it makes more sense. For example, when they say, I want to work on this, or I want to work in this area, or I want to work in this other area, okay? So to take that into account, tomar eso en cuenta. To listen to them. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did you have in your employees?
Number five allows to for changes in the schedule. Permitir los para los cambios en las tareas. Allow for changes in the schedules. Permisos para cambiar las tareas, así sería. Sería una traducción.
Las tareas. Algo así.
Y les parece apropiado. Do you think it's appropriate to these objectives?
No.
Mucho nos pega.
Usted dice que no pega.
Yo digo que no.
Bueno.
Pero
o sea, aquí dice que le permitamos cambiar las tareas. Entiendo que así es. Permitir cambio de tareas. No sé cómo lo traduce.
Ese permitir cambios en los horarios.
En el horario.
En los horarios.
Yo creo que sí.
Ah, entonces, sí, sí.
Sí, ese sí. Cambian las tareas, no mucho, pero.
Las tareas, no, en los horarios sí.
Horarios.
Permitir cambios en los horarios.
Sí, es como ser flexible, digamos.
Correcto, eso sí.
Ok, number six. Prevent absenteeism.
I said that you need to select two, okay? The idea is that you select two and you explain your decision, all right? So you need to select two and you explain your decision. Yeah, because if you select too many, I mean, the activity will take too long, all right? So the idea is that you select two and you explain your decision, okay? And the pronunciation for this is absenteeism.
Absenteeism.
Yeah. Okay.
Prevent absenteeism using phone reminders. Prever el ausentismo sería esto. Absentismo es.
Yes.
Prever el ausentismo usando recordatorios en el teléfono. What do you say? Gloria, what did you say?
Creo que no va, creo yo, ¿verdad? Porque te digo, o sea, estamos.
No. Ok, no, entonces hagamos lo siguiente.
Para decirme, no va a faltar ni nada, no sé.
Sí, no. Ok. The teacher is. We only have two options. Have three. Entonces, discard one. Discard es descartar. Teacher.
Communicate quickly with employee.
Sería la tercera, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Y la cuarta. Programe teniendo en cuenta. Las fortalezas.
Okay.
De sus empleados.
Yes. Strength.
Uh-huh.
What is Vaya. The pronunciation, teacher?
Sorry.
Stream.
What do you want to say?
Fortaleza.
Strength.
Strength.
Yeah, strength. Strength.
Strength.
Yeah.
Repeat, teacher, please.
Strength.
Strength. Strength.
Yes.
Strength.
Yeah, that's the pronunciation. Strength. Strength.
Strength.
Yeah.
Strength. Okay. Strengths. Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Teacher, la palabra de absenteeism.
Yeah.
What is the pronunciation?
Absenteeism. Absenteeism.
Absenteeism.
Teasing. 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 Teasing.
Absenteeism.
Yeah.
What
absenteeism.
Is...
Absenteeism. Absenteeism.
¿Cuál es esa florcita?
Absenteeism.
¿En qué número está? ¿Cuál es esa?
Six.
Ah. Prevenga.
Absenteeism.
Absenteeism. Es difícil.
15 veces vamos a pronunciarla, Angelita.
¿Vale? Absenteeism.
Absenteeism. Okay, using phone reminders. Reminders. Okay. Teacher, de las dos, son seis, de esas íbamos a elegir dos, las cuales íbamos a explicar por qué las elegimos, ¿cierto?
Ah, pues, yes.
Estamos en lo correcto, Francisco. Eso era. Thank you.
Hurry up, we have 5 minutes. Hurry up, okay. We have 5 minutes. Okay?
Okay, teacher. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Vamos a explicarlo. Lo voy a hacer en Spanish y luego lo traducimos, ¿cómo sería? Después no voy a poder hablar ni el español ni el inglés. Lo traducimos.
Teacher,
yes.
¿Cómo podríamos relacionar la tercera? Que es tomar en cuenta las preferencias en el trabajo con understaffing.
What I recommend is that you do it in general, okay? But when it says taking working preferences into account, it's like when you say preferences, it's like employees' preferences, okay?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, no es la como las prefer que tener preferencias, okay? So just to make the difference, okay? Yeah. So for understaffing, you can say that it's important because I mean, if you don't do it, if you don't take their preferences into account, probably. They will stop working in the company and you will have understaffing. Si no tomamos en cuenta esas preferencias que ellos tienen por lo que quieren hacer, probablemente no van a estar a gusto.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. If somebody say, I only want to do this thing. Exactly.
That's a working preference.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Yo impongo, ¿cómo dice yo impongo?
I tell them what to do.
I decide what to do.
or I command what they have to do. I command the ordinance. I command.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. We have to explain one.
Two.
Okay, one of
you select two options. You explain
The two options.
Yes.
Ah, okay.
The two options you select, you are going to explain, okay?
Okay. Two for overstanding and two for under.
I think you can do it in if you want to do it like specifically, it's okay. But you can do it in general if you want. Just one explanation for understaffing and overstaffing.
Ah, okay. Okay, Jancy, entonces, we choose number three. To explain. Or understaffing. And overstaffing.
Mm-hmm.
Number five.
Six.
Yeah. For under, number three. And for over, number four. We have to explain this.
I have the number three in six under staff and and five over staff.
Okay. And number six for understaffing.
Six.
Okay. Follows for change. But we have to explain that. How we can explain number five?
Five.
Allow for changes in the schedule.
Is overstaffing because how do you say permitir?
Hello. It's like the first. Hello.
Rotación de personal.
If we are rotating the personnel,
rotate staff. Or staff rotate.
No. If we are rotating. If we are rotating the staff. If we are rotating the staff, we have more opportunities, more.
Yes, rotation.
Rotating. Si estamos rotando al personal. Al permitir cambios en la schedule, podemos rotar más al personal.
Porque permite rotación del personal.
Rotating es rotando.
Solo usa permitir todo. Because. A low rotation staff. Only.
Let me write.
And number six.
For example, at work, the technicians have the schedule.
Tenemos que cenar temprano. Ahí viene el
tiempo. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
The one option
is number two. In the case, find a method to communicate quickly with employees. Sure.
Why?
Because they are suited to prevent everyone from reaching the same place the same place.
In the same time.
In the same time. Okay.
Okay. The option for understaffing.
And the
option for understaffing.
And the option is for me number six. Number six. Prevent absenteeism. ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Absenteeism.
Using phone remind. ¿Cómo se pronuncia ese teacher?
Reminders. Phone reminders.
Reminders.
Yeah. Phone reminders.
Why you choose that option, Ada?
Excuse me. Estoy copiando el cómo se pronuncia.
Why do choose that option?
Number six, because ya le ay, ese sí no sé. I don't know.
That way all employees arrive at the most convenient time for work.
Repeat, please.
That way, all employees arrive at the most
labores.
¿Cómo lo dejó al final a salir?
Es cuando la empresa le permite al empleado poder cambiar el horario o turno que solicita según sus necesidades. Y a la vez que no afecte en las labores. No afecte las labores, diarias.
En ese final le puse... Ah, y que no genere impactos negativos. Generate negative impact.
Negative impact.
No le escuché aquí con ruido.
Vaya, entonces pongamos la primera parte de Azalia y cómo usted termina la oración, Susana.
Ok. Entonces podría ser también. Que no afecte también. En inglés también. Que no afecte la producción.
Ajá, que en vez de que no genere. No, porque igual podría no hacerlo solamente en producción, porque también hay actividades administrativas.
Ajá, es cierto. No solo es para
producción. Entonces las labores diarias.
Las labores diarias.
En todo caso, usted representa la dos y Darwin la primera.
Ok.
¿Le parece?
Se aprueba por 84 votos.
Eso.
Sí, 63, señor diputado.
Diga. Hi, teacher. I'm sorry you don't speak Spanish.
Ay, teacher, no lo habíamos visto.
I'm spying you.
Okay, Azalia, usted la dos y yo la uno.
Qué fácil de convencer, Darwin.
Sí, ya vi, habíamos quedado que nosotras.
Okay, I hope everyone finished because everybody was discussing, but I can give you more time for this, okay? If you have the explanation for one only, you explain only one, all right? So, but the idea in the activity was that you selected two strategies and to explain the two strategies, right? Okay, so we are going to listen to some participations, okay? Like four participations maybe. So let's listen to, so for the people I select, explain, I mean, read the strategies and explain the strategies, okay? You can say, we selected a strategy number one, and you read it, and then you explain, okay? So let me see, Susana, can you?
Teacher,
can't hear
no
you.
Teacher.
Some of.
Teacher, can you audio?
Now, can you listen to me?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Mm-hmm. The idea is that you say the two strategies you selected and you explain the two strategies you selected. Okay. So we are going to start then, and let's see, Susana. We are going to listen to three or four participations, okay? Let's see, Susana, can you give me a number from 1 to 10, please? Susana?
Number four.
Number four. One, yes. Two, three, four. Rosa, okay? Rosa, so you can start. Okay, let's listen to Rosa.
Oh my God, so difficult. I don't know how can I explain that. But, oh my God.
You can do try. It, Rosa.
That's right.
Oh my God. Okay. We choose option number 3 and number 6 for understaffing. Number 3 is they working preference into account. And number 6, prevent absenteeism using phone reminders. Oh my God. After I'm going to explain. For overstaffing, we chose schedule having your employees strengths in mind and allow for change in the schedule. Oh my God. I'm going to explain allow for change in the schedule for overstaffing.
Okay. Flexibility. All right. Continue.
Yes. We think with Jancy that if we allow for changes in the schedule, we are going to have more staff, more personnel for another activity. If someone go out in the morning and do the work in a few hours, the person or the staff can come back to the office and it's available to do something more in the afternoon.
Okay.
I understand. We understand in that way.
Yeah. It's okay.
Okay. Only that.
Okay. Okay, it's fine. Okay, thank you very much, Rosa and Jancy.
Okay. I can explain the number 3, the understaffing.
Okay,
the taking working preference into account is understaffing because we can delegate the activities to be carried out to each person according to what they went to achieve, lograr, lo que quieres
lograr. It's okay,
lograr.
Achieve, it's okay.
Uh-huh. Only that, de acuerdo a lo que quieres lograr.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you, Rosa and Jancy. Okay, we give the hearts later, okay, don't worry. Okay, now let's see, Rosa, can you select another person, please, to chair.
say a name or say a number?
A name, please.
A name. Da, 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 da. Oh. Oh my God. Adriana.
Okay, Adriana, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Who is your pair or who is in your group?
Ana Michelle and Mayra.
Okay, are you going to present alone or you are going to present together?
Only me.
Okay.
No creo que no problem. we select the strategy number two and number four. The number two is find a method to communicate quickly with employees. This strategy because helps us to solve conflict and provide feedback to employees, achieve effective communication. And our strategy number four say schedule having your employees strengths in mind. This strategy helps us organize employees depending on their ability and strengths, generating a good work environment.
Okay, I like it. Very good. Okay, a good work atmosphere. You can say atmosphere. A good work atmosphere instead of saying environment. Okay, atmosphere. Okay.
Atmosphere.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's
atmosphere.
Better.
Atmosphere.
Yeah, it's better. Okay. Thank you very much, Adriana and her group. Okay. Thank you for your explanation. And let's listen to a last group. Escuchemos un último grupo. Okay. Let's see. Adriana, select another group, please.
Azalia.
Okay. Azalia, who is in your group, Azalia?
Hoy la quiero más.
Who is in your group, Azalia?
Darwin and Susan.
Susan and?
Darwin.
And Darwin, okay. So are you going to present alone or together?
Darwin is there.
Okay, Darwin. Let's listen to Darwin.
Okay, thanks for opportunity. We are a select strategy number two and number five. I explained number two. Number two, find a method to communicate quickly with employees. I select the strategy because facilitates the way of transmission the message. For example, a group of WhatsApp, Outlook, a bulletin board, and another method in the company. Next, Natalia.
Okay, I think it could be the strategy of number five. Allow for change in the schedule. It is when the company allows the employee to change the schedule or chief request according to your needs, and at the same time that is doesn't affect the daily work of the company.
Okay, I like it. Thank you very much. So you say according to your needs or according to their needs. What is correct? According to your needs or according to their needs. What is correct? ¿Qué es correcto? Yes?
Their needs.
Their needs. Sus necesidades de ellos, no tus necesidades, okay? So it's according to their needs, okay? Their needs, okay? Thank you very much, Darwin, Azalia, and who else? And Susan, all right. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you for your participations. Now, please, everybody, go to reactions and let's give them a heart. Let's give these groups a heart. Thank you for your participations, okay? I want to listen to everybody, but we don't have so much time, okay? The preparation took too much time. And now let's go to the next activity. And on a PPT, okay, on a PowerPoint, I have, okay, hold on a second. I have these questions. Now listen, for these questions, you are not going to write the answers. You are not going to write the answers. Only have the answers on your mind, okay? Solo traten de tener las respuestas en su mente. So question number one is, how are employees monitored at your company? How are employees monitored at your company? ¿Cómo son monitoreados los empleados en tu compañía? I have one example here. The supervisor keeps observing everyone in the company. El supervisor se mantiene observándolos a todos en la compañía. That's my example. But if you want to say this, no problem. Or you can say a different strategy. I don't know. All right? Question number two. What kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job? All right? ¿Qué clase de documentación es usada en tu compañía para asegurarse que los empleados están haciendo un buen trabajo? I have here, they use a checklist. Usan una lista de cotejo. Or you can say maybe they use a verification checklist. Or they observe. I don't know. All right, it's your decision, okay? So I give you 3 minutes. In 3 minutes, think about the answer. It's about your company, okay? Es acerca de su compañía. It's about your company. How are employees monitored at your company? ¿Cómo son monitoreados los empleados en tu compañía? Number two, what kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job? ¿Qué clase de documentación se usa en tu compañía para asegurar que los empleados están haciendo un buen trabajo? Okay. You can say reports. I don't know. Okay, a report. A checklist, an observation list, okay? Oh, we don't use any documentation, you can say, right? No usamos documentación, we don't use any documentation, you can say, okay? It's your answer. Just a short answer, please, okay? Una respuesta corta, a short answer, please.
Papá, Okay, are you ready? Can we start? Yes, no?
No, teacher, no.
Oh my goodness. Okay, we'll start with some people. And the others can continue like answering the questions if you want, okay? Okay, let's see. We are going to start with, let me see here, some people who haven't participated. Okay, let me see. We are going to start with Miguel, all right? Miguel, all right. So let's see, Miguel. How are employees monitored at your company? The microphone, Miguel.
It's for, they are reviewing by means of a work plan.
Okay, so you have a work plan, right? And they are monitored according to a work plan.
Yes. In this plan, which ones are were carried out?
Okay. Can you repeat the last part, please? I didn't listen to you very well.
In this plan, it seems which ones were carried out.
Ah, I see. Okay, very interesting. Okay, thank you very much. Second question. What kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job?
In my workplace, exists the no terminé de traducir evaluación del desempeño.
Ah, okay. Development, you can say, or performance. You can say performance evaluation.
Yes.
Performance evaluation. Okay, performance evaluation. Okay, we have a performance evaluation.
Yes, we have a performance evaluation.
Okay, very interesting. Thank you very much, Miguel. I like the answer for the first. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so now let's listen to another participation with this. Okay, Lourdes, are you ready? Kind of, a little.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Yes.
Okay, Lourdes, how are employees monitored at your company?
In my company, the employees are monitored. Because we use a Skype Enterprise and we have a system that when our computer is on, the system starts to count the minutes and register your start hour and finish hour. Also, in some occasions, the IT area into the PC or computer when we work.
Ah, okay, very interesting. So they monitor you through the computer.
Yes.
Oh, interesting. I like it. Very interesting. So what kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job?
In my company, only the documents that register what is the result of the KPI is. KPIs.
Okay, what is that?
Indicates that the employee have a good job. For example, the employee is punctuality, the employee has not a falta, I don't know.
An absence
and another indicates that the specific area needs to evaluate the employee.
Okay, very interesting. Okay, thank you very much. That's very good. Thank you. All right.
Thank you.
Okay, Susana, do you have the answers? Susan? Yes, okay, let's see. Question number one. How
yes.
are employees monitored at your company?
Okay, in my job,
Well, in my case, the immediate boss. In other areas like production, they have a supervisors.
Okay, but how do they monitor? Do they observe? Do they talk to you, or how do they do it? ¿Cómo lo hacen? How do they do it?
Oh, like result?
Oh, okay, according to the result.
You know, you have your activities, then you make the answers, the results, the meetings, the revisions.
Okay. I see. Okay, thank you. Okay, question number two. What kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job?
Okay, in the office, we use the result based in planner. Yes, we have a planner, their activities.
Oh, I see. Very interesting.
In each activity, you make the result.
Oh, I see. Okay, very interesting.
Yes. And in production, okay, there are cameras, logs, and stuff that roaming in the areas. In the same result like order, the production.
Okay, so you have logs and cameras.
Yes.
Okay, very interesting. Okay, thank you very much, Susana. Very good.
Thank you.
Okay, let's listen to a last opinion, a volunteer. A volunteer. Okay, who me? Say the name, please, Angela, right?
Yes.
Okay, let's listen to Angela. Okay, Angela, how are employees monitored at your company?
In my work, employees are monitored by video cameras.
Video cameras. Good. What kind of documentation is used in your company to make sure employees are doing a good job?
In my world, there is no document, only through the person in charge of the branch.
Okay, so there is no document. Only the person in charge keeps observing.
Yes.
Okay, very interesting. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for your participations. Now, please, everyone, go to reactions and let's give participations a wow, all right? Let's give them a wow. Let me see here who's giving wows and who is not giving wows. Okay, now everybody is. Okay, thank you very much. So let me pass the attendance quickly and we go to the next activity. Ada?
Present.
Very good. Adriana?
Present, teacher.
Michelle?
Present.
Okay. Angela?
Present, teacher.
Darwin?
Present, teacher.
Flor?
Present, teacher.
Gloria?
Here.
Joanna? I think Joanna is connected. I saw Joanna connected. Yes, right, she was connected. Okay. Lourdes?
Present, teacher.
Margarita?
I'm here.
Okay, Margarita, Mayra?
Present.
Okay, Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Nelson? He's in a meeting, right? Ophelia?
Here, teacher.
Okay, Osmin?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Rafael?
Present.
Rosa?
Present.
Sandra? Sandra? Yancy?
Present.
Okay. Zulma? Zulma? Azalia? Azalia?
Present.
Okay. Ingrid? And Susana?
Present.
Okay. Thank you.
Dice, ya estoy aquí.
Ok, thank you, Johanna. Ya vamos a ponerle aquí asistencia. Ok, Johanna, yes. Ok, thank you very much. Now, let's go to the next activity. And in the next activity, we have a short, let me show you here. We have a short, hold on a second. Give me a second. My goodness. Okay, so on the next activity, we have a short conversation, but I want you to pay attention to some structures, okay? And I will say the structures a little bit like louder. As you can see, some structures are in bold. Okay, hay unas estructuras en negrita. You have some structures in bold. So pay attention to pronunciation, but pay attention to these sentences in bold. Okay, so listen, please. Listen carefully and check pronunciation. Where's Mario? He's late for his shift. Mario? Goodness, I got a call that he is very sick. I should have told you earlier. I should have told you earlier. Don't worry, he should have called me directly. If he had called me to my phone, I could have found a substitute by now. He should have called me directly. If he had called to my phone, I could have found a substitute by now. I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him. Listen again, please. Where's Mario? He's late for his shift. Mario? Goodness, I got a call that he is very sick. I should have told you earlier. Don't worry, he should have called me directly. If he had called to my phone, I could have found a substitute by now. I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him. Now, I want to ask you this. I should have told you earlier. How do you say this in Spanish?
Debía haberlo dicho más temprano.
Ah, debía haberle dicho más temprano. O debía haberte dicho más temprano, right? Good. Should is like debí. Okay, I should. Yo debí. I should have. Yo debí haber. Haberle dicho. Told is the past participle of the verb tell. All right? Let's check the second example. He should have called me directly. How do you say this in Spanish? He should have called me directly.
Debió
haberme llamado directamente. He should have called me directly. Now, let's see the other example. Oh my goodness, hold on a second. Okay, look at this example. I could have found a substitute by now. How do you say this in Spanish? In this case, is not. Pude, in past, okay? Pude podría. Haber. Pude, in past, okay? Pude.
Podría. No podría. Haber encontrado un sustituto.
Exactly. Yo pude haber ahora. Encontrado un sustituto ahora. En este momento, ajá, by now, okay? En ese momento, by now, en ese momento, all right, en este momento, okay? Good. So I could have found a substitute. Pude haber encontrado un sustituto. So could is pude and should is debí. Now listen. In these structures we see the verb is in past participle. El verbo está en una forma que tal vez no conocemos. This form is past participle. Esta forma se llama pasado participio. This form is called past participle. We are going to check it in a moment. Ya lo vamos a ver en un momento, okay? So by now let's listen to Ada and Osmin. Osmin, kitchen manager. Ada, Mary. So let's listen to their pronunciation. Please.
All right. Okay. Where's Mario? He is late for the chef.
Mario, goodness, I got a call that he is very sick. I should have told you earlier.
Worry. He is a sore half. Call me. Call me directly. He have called to my phone. I call have found a substitute by now.
I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. That's excellent. So let's listen to Michelle and Mayra. The C's. Okay, So Michelle and Mayra, let's listen to Michelle and Mayra. Michelle, kitchen manager. Mayra, Mary.
Sisters.
Yeah, the sisters.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna start. Where's Mario? He's late for his shift.
Goodness, I got a call that he's very sick. I should have told you earlier.
Don't worry, he should have called me directly. If he had called to my phone, I could have found a substitute by now.
I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him.
Okay, that's excellent. Very good. So now let's listen to Adriana and Rosa. Okay, Rosa, kitchen manager, Adriana, Mary.
Okay. Where's Mario? He's late for his shift.
Mario? Goodness, I got a call that he's very sick. I should have told you earlier.
Don't worry. He should have called me directly. If he called to my phone, I could have found a substitute by now.
I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him.
Okay, thank you very much. That's excellent. Now let's listen to Margarita and Flor. Margarita, kitchen manager, Flor, Mary. Hello, Margarita. Mm-hmm. All right, let's listen to Dan. Let's listen to Azalia and Flor, okay? Azalia, kitchen manager, Margarita, Mary. I mean, Flor, Mary. Ready?
Sorry.
Where is Mario? He's late for teacher lo movió.
I'm sorry. How is there, Azalia?
Where's Mario? He's late for his shift.
Mario, goodness, I got a call that he's very sick. I should have told you early.
Don't worry. He should have called me directly. If he had called to me my phone, I call her phone. I substitute by now.
I have time this afternoon. Let me cover for him.
Okay, thank you. That's excellent. Let's listen to Jancy and Osmin. Osmin, kitchen manager. I mean, Osmin participated, right? Ya participó, Osmin?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, right. So, Ofelia, okay. Let's listen to Ofelia and Jancy, okay? Let's see, Jancy, kitchen manager, Ofelia, Mary.
Okay. Where's Mario? He's late for this trip.
Mario, he's very sick. I sure has told you earlier.
Don't worry. He sure have called me directly. If he have called to my phone, he could have found a substitute by now.
I had my ideas afternoon less. I may cover for his.
For him, all right. Let me cover for him. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, now please, everybody, go to reactions and give your classmates a like or a heart or a wow, whatever you want. Okay, whatever you want, a heart, a wow, or a like, or confetti. Congratulations. Okay, so please go to reactions. Okay, thank you very much for your participation, okay, in this activity. Thank you for volunteering. Gracias por ofrecerse de voluntarios para hacer la conversación. Thank you very much. I appreciate that, okay? Yo aprecio mucho eso. I appreciate
forever,
that.
Forever, teacher, forever.
Okay, thank you very much. And Angela is giving a heart. She agrees with me, I guess. Okay, thank you. All right, now let's see. Let's go to the next activity. And in the next activity, we are going to make use of vocabulary from the conversation, okay? And we have these sentences, okay? Do you remember how to complete the first sentence? This one? How can I complete the first sentence? Do you remember? Check the conversation if you don't remember.
Should have told.
Ah, exactly. How can you complete it?
I should have told.
Oh, I will make it bigger so I can write. Okay, I should have what?
Told.
All right. Yes. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Y aquí la L, right? I'm sorry, okay? I should have told you earlier. How do you complete the second? He should have called me directly. He should have called me directly, okay? And the last one, number three?
I could have found.
Es el pasado participio del verbo find, que es encontrar, okay? I could have found a substitute by now. Oh my goodness, you're really paying attention. Thank you very much. Okay. And now let's go to the next activity quickly, okay? This is just a little introduction to the topic we are going to study in a moment, okay? But before that, let me stop sharing this. And we have other questions, okay? And in these questions we have, let me share on the PPT. On these questions we have here, I have just a little way about how to answer the questions, okay? So question number one is, have you ever gotten? What is gotten? Any idea what is gotten? Es el past participle del verbo get, que es conseguir. So have you ever gotten is like alguna vez has a last minute notice, okay? Has tenido, in this case, obtenido a last minute notice about a member of your staff not going to work. Is like in Spanish, it would be alguna vez has tenido una notificación de último minuto acerca de un compañero de trabajo que no va a ir a trabajar. That's the question, right? You say, yes, I have. No, I haven't. Yeah.
¿Alguna vez has tenido o no puede decir alguna vez has recibido, verdad?
Podría ser recibido. It's better.
¿Alguna vez has recibido un aviso de última hora sobre?
Yes. Yeah, it's better. It's better. Okay. Thank you very much. I like the translation. So let's say, ¿alguna vez has recibido alguna notificación, aviso de última hora acerca de un compañero de trabajo que no va a ir a trabajar? Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Okay. Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Question number two. How did you handle the situation? ¿Cómo lo manejaste? How did you handle the situation? I notified my boss. Or I didn't do anything. No sé. I don't know. All right. Did you get a substitute? ¿Conseguiste un sustituto? Did you get a substitute? Then you say, yes, I did or no, I didn't, right? Yes, I did or no, I didn't. Did you assume some of the absent employees' responsibility? ¿Asumiste, I mean in the past, en el pasado, alguna responsabilidad de un empleado que estaba ausente? Ausente, perdón. Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Okay, so four questions, okay? If you ask me, Bernardo, have you ever gotten a last minute notice about a member of your staff not going to work? Yes, I have. In my case, right? Yes, I have. How did you handle the situation? Well, in my case, I notified my boss. Did you get a substitute? No, I didn't, because I'm not the boss. Okay. No soy el jefe. I'm not the boss. So no, I didn't. Okay. Did you assume some of the absent employees' responsibility? Yes, I have. many times, muchas veces. Yes, I have many times, right? Muchas veces lo he asumido, el trabajo, la responsabilidad de los que les gusta faltar, okay? So, yes, I have, all right? Good. So, please, don't write the answers. No escriban las respuestas. Aquí solo me van a decir, yes, I have, no, I haven't. Okay? Only for question number two, ¿a quién le notificaron? I notify my colleague, I notify my boss, I notify my supervisor, I notify my manager, I notify human resources, I don't know, okay? Yeah? So let's see, a los que no han participado, Gloria. Question number one, Gloria. Have you ever gotten a last minute notice about a member of your staff not going to work? Yes, I have or no, I haven't?
Yes, I have.
Yes, I have. How did you handle the situation? ¿Cómo manejó la situación?
I notify.
I notify.
For me.
I notify.
I
don't hear you very well, Gloria. Casi no se escucha, Gloria. Can you repeat your answer, please?
The department.
You notify?
And me?
Notify is the boss, teacher.
Sorry?
Gloria is the boss.
Ah, she's the boss. Oh my goodness. So you didn't notify. Okay. You only put the permission, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Okay, Gloria, did you get a substitute?
I have a work.
You are the substitute.
Yes.
Okay. Did you assume some of the absent employees' responsibility? The last question, la última pregunta.
Yes, I have.
Okay, thank you very much, Gloria. Okay, let's listen to a boy. We have a long time not listening to a boy. Okay, let's listen to, well, we only have two boys today, right? Participating in the class. We only have Miguel and Darwin, and Osmin, sorry, three boys. Okay, so let's listen to Darwin. We have a long time not listening to Darwin. Okay, Darwin, have you ever gotten a last minute notice about a member of your staff not going to work?
Yes, I have.
Good. How did you handle the situation?
In my case, I notified my boss and the other co-workers.
Oh, nice. Very good. Did you get a substitute?
No, I didn't, because I don't the boss.
I'm not the boss, you can say. I'm not the boss. Okay.
I'm not the boss.
Yes. Last question. Did you assume some of the absent employees' responsibility?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
Responsibility.
Okay. Okay, very good. Aquí la respuesta está equivocada. Aquí sería yes, I did. Okay. Yes, ahorita estoy viendo. Yes, I did y no I didn't, porque la pregunta empieza con did. Okay. So there is a mistake. It would be like number three. Sería como la número tres. Yes, I did. No, I didn't, okay? There is a mistake, hay un pequeño error, there is a little mistake, okay? Good, thank you very much, Darwin, and let's listen to a last participation. Let me see, ¿a quién no hemos escuchado? Ayúdenme, por favor, ¿a quién no hemos escuchado hoy? De los que están. Help me, please, tell me a name.
Sandra.
Joanna.
Sandra and Joanna, okay? Okay, let's see, Joanna. Joanna, have you ever gotten a last minute notice about a member of your staff not going to work?
Yes, I have.
How did you handle the situation?
I notified my boss.
Okay. Did you get a substitute?
Yes, I did.
Good. You or your boss?
No, I am not.
I mean, you said yes, right? But you or your boss got the substitute. ¿Quién consiguió el sustituto? Who? You or your boss?
My boss.
Yeah, your boss, okay. Did you assume some of the absent employees' responsibility?
No.
Yes, I did.
I haven't.
No, I didn't.
No, I didn't.
Okay, thank you very mucho. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much. Okay. Oh my goodness. Now, for the next part, thank you. Oh, please go to reactions and give whatever you want, okay? I will give confetti this time, all right? So go to reactions and give a heart, a like, give anything, all right? You can give another emoji if you want, okay? We have different emojis, so we can give them an emoji, all right? Highlight flowers emoji. Okay, thank you very much. Good. Now listen, please. Listen, please. Carefully, thoroughly. In the next part, I need full attention, please. Okay? Los kids, mándenselos al papá ahorita, okay? Y los chicos que tienen kids, mándenselos a la esposa ahorita, okay? Send them to their wives, okay? Please. So I need, no, I'm kidding, okay? I'm kidding, but I need a lot of attention for this part, okay? Because this topic for today is not so easy. So I want you to be really focused, really paying attention, okay? Good. So let's get started. So listen, here I have first, just before I go over the topic, I have a list of verbs, okay? I want you to take a moment and to take a look at these verbs. I have the verbs in three forms, present, past, and past participle. And I have two short lists. Tengo dos listas cortas, okay? Present, past, and past participle, okay? So please take 2 minutes and check the verbs. And if you want, make a screenshot, okay? Y si quieren, me hacen una captura para que la tengan ahí. If you want, make a screenshot, so you have it there. Okay, so basically the verbs are in three forms, okay? Present, past, and past participle. For today, we are going to focus on the past participle, okay? So, and as you can see, these are regular verbs. Estos son verbos regulares. Why regular? ¿Por qué regulares? Porque solo les ponemos ed o usamos una regla para modificarlos. En la forma pasado y forma pasado participio. So it's easy, right? So the same form in past and the same form in past participle. The same form in past and the same form in past participle. So no problem, okay? So for accept, in past participle, you say accepted, okay? For agree, you say agreed. For ask, you say asked. For believe, you say believed. For call, you say called. Y teníamos esta en la conversación, right? We had this in the conversation, called. For close, we say closed. For decide, we say decided, decided. For discuss, we say discussed. For end, we say ended, ended. For fill, we say filled, filled. For help, we say helped, helped. For invite, we say invited. Ahí hay un spelling, okay? Un typo, no le pongan atención. Es con I, okay? It's with I. Invited, okay? Invited. For learn, we say learned, listened, moved, needed, okay, played, and walked. Okay, so now these verbs are regular. And in the past participle, they are the same in the past and the same in the past participle, okay? Son lo mismo en pasado y en pasado participio, ¿ya? Ya estudiamos el pasado, ¿verdad? No sé si lo estudiaron conmigo o con el otro profesor, pero we studied the past, okay? Good. Now, today we are paying attention to the past participle. Past participle. Now let me show you another list. Check this. Revisen esto. Check this, please. A lo que está a la par, no le pongan atención. Es la pronunciación, okay? Don't pay attention to that. Only check the verbs. Solo revisen esos verbos. The same. They are in three forms. Present, past, and past participle, okay? Present, past, and past participle. Pueden hacer una captura si quieren también. You can make a screenshot if you want. Okay, now pay attention. Now pay attention. These are irregular verbs. Estos son verbos irregulares. Why irregular? Because they change the present, the past, and the past participle is different. Aquí ya no le vamos a poner ed. Esto cambia totalmente. This changes, okay, totally, okay? For example, for the verb to be, el famoso verb to be, in past you say was where, pero en past participle decimos been. Been, all right, we say been. Come, llegar, came in the past, and come in the past participle. Do, hold on a second. Okay, do in the present. Okay, déjenme buscar el lápiz óptico que por aquí lo tenía. Okay, so I say did in the past and done in the past participle. Nos vamos a enfocar en el past participle, done. So done is like hecho. It's like when I say, for example, yo he hecho, I have done, okay? Usamos el verbo have, I have done. Drink, drunk, drunk, okay? En pasado participio, drunk. Eat, in past participle, eaten. Cambia la forma totalmente, right? So it's very different because in past we say ate. In past participle, we say eaten. Get. Got. Aquí este got, de ahí está en inglés británico, pero en inglés americano es gotten, ¿ok? In American English is gotten, ¿ok? Give, dar. Gave in the past, given in the past participle. Given, dado. Yo he dado, I have given, ¿all right? Go, went in the past, gone in the past participle. Learn, learned. Learned. Este puede llevar dos formas. Si se fijan, aparecía también en el otro listado, ¿verdad? ¿Sí? Aparecía con D en el otro listado. Este puede ser regular o irregular. ¿Ok? Puede ser con T o con ED. It's your decision. Ustedes deciden cuál van a usar. You decide which one you are using. ¿Ok? Make. Made. Made. Run. 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 See. Ver, so, seen, visto, yo he visto, I have seen, all right? Take, tomar, took, taken, taken. A ese taken le vamos a poner atención ahorita, ¿ok? Write, wrote, written. A ese written le vamos a poner atención. Yo he escrito dos reportes. I have written two reports, ¿ok? Now, le hicieron captura, right? Did you make a screenshot? Yes?
Yes, yes.
Yes, teacher, thank you.
Now, in general, we have a difference between regular and irregular verbs. What is the difference?
La forma de...
La forma.
Ajá, del presente, del pasado y del...
Past participle.
Pasado participle. Yes. Yes.
For example, in regular verbs, what do we do? En verbos regulares, ¿qué hacemos? In regular verbs, what do we do?
Agregar el R.
Ah, le agregamos ED. Easy, right?
Yes.
ED, depende de la regla. Si termina en Y, así como los adjetivos, le quitamos la Y y le ponemos IED. Así como lo que vimos ayer, ¿ok? Yeah. So it's very basic, it's very easy. But in irregular verbs, what happens?
The verb changes.
The verb changes. Exactly, Lourdes. The verb changes. In the present, in the past, and in the past participle, the verb changes the majority of the times. El verbo cambia la mayoría de veces. The verb changes the majority of the time. The verb changes the majority of the times. Okay? Yeah? Good. Siempre, por favor, si al momento de participar, encienden el micrófono y después papá, ¿ok? Así. Ok, please. All right, please. Ok. So, irregular verbs are different. Then, ¿cuál es la solución para los verbos irregulares entonces? Can you tell me this? What is the solution for this?
Memorizarlos.
Ah, to learn them by heart. To learn them by heart, aprendérselo de memoria, by heart, de corazón, no es de corazón, by heart, es de memoria, es una frase que se usa en inglés, ok, by heart, es de memoria, ok, by heart, ok, so you need to learn the verbs by heart, por eso es que les hacía la recomendación, si han estudiado verbos,
it's important,
it's not important, it's very important, ok, it's very important, ok, good, now,
very,
but this is not the topic. This is part of the topic. Ese no es el tema en sí. Necesitamos eso para el tema de hoy. We need that for today's topic, okay? Now, let's go to today's topic. So look, just try to remember that. So look, and pay attention carefully, please. For today's topic, okay, the idea in today's topic is to express regret. To express regret. Expresar arrepentimiento, okay, to express regret, or remorse. What is remorse? ¿Qué es remorse?
Remordimiento,
that's right, to express regret or remorse. Ajá, para expresar arrepentimiento, remordimiento about past actions, right? And we have the structure. The structure is, should have, y el verbo en past participle. All right, should have and the verb in past participle. For example, I should have, y el verbo en pasado participio, sent, que es el pasado participio de send, enviar. I should have sent the report sooner. How do you say this in Spanish?
Más pronto,
ok, good, so I should have sent the report sooner, o antes, podríamos decir, ok, so, sent, aquí entra entonces el dilema, sent es el pasado participio de send, pero si no lo supiera, I say sent, right, or sended, o incluso si no lo supiera, le voy a poner ed, I say sented, no, all right, the only way is sent, ok, so that is correct. Okay, let's look at the other one. Shouldn't. Podemos usar el negativo también. Okay. Este está fácil. It's very easy because it's regular. I shouldn't have asked her to carry those boxes. Okay. Shouldn't is like no debí, right? It's negative. Okay. Good. How do you say this sentence in Spanish?
No debí haberle pedido que llevara esas cajas.
Exactly. Exactly. I shouldn't have asked her to carry those boxes. No debí haberle pedido que llevara esas cajas. So it's regret. Okay? It's regret. Es arrepentimiento. It's regret, right? La estructura should have in the past participle, right? Yes, to talk about regrets. Now let's look at the other part. Now listen, but here I have a more complex structure. Aquí tengo una estructura más compleja. I have a more complex structure. Why? Porque aquí tengo if, el had, y otro pasado participio. It's a more complete sentence. Es una oración más completa. And now look at this. If I had known. Known. ¿De qué verbo viene el pasado participio known?
Know.
Del verbo know. Conocer. Ajá, known. Okay, then I say, if I had known, si hubiera, si hubiese o hubiera, I don't know. Okay, si hubiese sabido que estabas enfermo, okay? Si hubiese sabido que estabas enfermo, if I had known. And then I could have, aquí tenemos could have, no should have. I could have gotten a substitute. Yo pudiese haber conseguido un sustituto. Okay? Yeah?
Podría decirse, podría haber conseguido un sustituto.
Ajá. Podría, ajá. Sí, creo que es el mejor de hecho. Ajá, podría haber conseguido un sustituto. Exactly. Podría haber conseguido un sustituto. Mm-hmm. It's better, I think. Ajá, okay. So then I said, entonces digo, si yo hubiese sabido que estabas enfermo, podría haber conseguido un sustituto. ¿Ok? O pude. Pero es que él podría... Es que si digo podría, yo siento que más estoy hablando en futuro y la idea no es hablar en futuro. Pude haber conseguido. It's for past actions, right? Pude haber conseguido un sustituto. Yes, that's right. Second example. The manager could have fixed your schedule. How do you say this in Spanish?
El gerente podría haber arreglado tu horario.
Pudo haber arreglado tu horario. Huh? If you had mentioned it to him, si se lo hubieses mencionado. Uh-huh. 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 Okay. And then we have the last. Tenemos el would ahora. Could have come. I would have come to work if I had received the schedule on time. Ese would, la vez pasada les dije que se traduce como el IA en español, ¿verdad? IA. All right?
IA. Yo habría.
Ajá. ¿Habría llegado a trabajar si hubiese recibido el horario a tiempo? Ajá. Uh-huh. Yes. Uh-huh. Habría llegado a trabajar si hubiese recibido el horario a tiempo. Okay? And we have the structure. Had and the verb in past participle. Okay? Let me check this quickly. Okay, so here we have the structure. If, had, and past participle, okay? So this is mainly for remorse, okay? So the idea is remorse. Any question? I know it's not so easy. This is more difficult, okay? But yes. Do you have any questions?
No, not this year. I memorize, como dijo la frase de...
Which phrase?
By heart.
Maybe here, tal vez acá lo que debemos manejar es la fórmula. The formula, okay? Las formulas. This is important here, okay? The formulas, okay? Had the verb in past participle, and in the other part, could or would. Could have or would have. Y el verbo siempre en pasado participio. ¿Ok?
Teacher, ahí siempre tiene que llevar el have.
Had. In this case, yes. En este caso, siempre lleva el had.
En el pasado participio y el verbo en pasado.
Yes, that's right.
Ok.
En pasado. Vaya, aquí esta es...
En pasado participio, el verbo en pasado participio, ¿sepa?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yes. Aquí llevamos esta estructura y el verbo en pasado participio y luego lo demás, ¿verdad? And then the rest. Could have and the verb in past participle, the same. I will give you some other examples, okay? Imagine I say, if, ¿quién no se conectó hoy? Didn't get connected today. Can you help me, please?
Zulma.
Zulma. Listen Sandra. To this Sandra. No, Sandra was connected. But listen to this example. Listen to my example. If Sandra had connected today, if Sandra had connected today, si Sandra se hubiese conectado hoy, had connected. Okay, el verbo connected en past participle. If Sandra had connected today, she could have learned a lot. Okay, she could have learned a lot. Okay? Ella podría haber aprendido mucho, maybe in this case. Ella pudo haber aprendido mucho, okay? Ella pudo haber aprendido mucho. If Sandra had connected today, she could have learned a lot. Y mañana Sandra va a decir, teacher, I should have connected yesterday. I should have connected yesterday. Debí haberme conectado ayer. I should have connected yesterday, okay? Le estoy dando ejemplos así en un contexto real para que tengan una mejor idea. So you have a better idea, okay? So, okay. Imagine Ana Michelle didn't understand the topic. Imagínense que Ana Michelle no entendió el tema. Y mañana Michelle me dice, teacher, you should have explained more about the topic. You should have explained more about the topic. Debió haber explicado más del tema. You should have explained more about the topic. Should have explained. Okay? Y luego me dice, teacher, if you had explained more, si hubiese explicado más, if you had explained more, I could have understood better. Pude haber entendido o pudiese haber entendido mejor, ¿ok?
Mejor.
Yeah. I could have understood better. El understood ya va en pasado participio del verbo understand, ¿ok? Yeah. Questions. Questions.
Thank you, teacher.
Teacher, este pasado participio solo se puede ocupar usando esas dos fórmulas.
No, se usa en otros propósitos, para otros tiempos verbales. But for today's purpose is this, right? But it's used for other tenses. Se usa en otros tiempos. It's used in other tenses.
Okay.
Pero por ahora quedemos con esto. Let's stay with this, all right? It's enough. It's enough. Miguel, yes, Miguel.
En el listado de los verbos irregulares, ¿son solo esos los irregulares o hay por ahí otros?
Sorry to disappoint you, pero los verbos irregulares son alrededor de 220. ¿Ok? Para que se vayan preparando mentalmente y para que se lo vayan aprendiendo, ¿ok? Y los regulares, yes.
And can you provide a list of verbs?
Yeah, sure.
For us.
Sure. Last time, Nelson provided a list. Okay, but I can provide you with one list, no problem. Now listen. Ahora bien. Now, I will speak Spanish a little bit. Ahora bien. Es más fácil que se aprendan los irregulares. No, es que yo me voy a aprender los regulares porque son más fáciles. Solo les pongo ED. It's okay. I mean, no problem. Okay. Pero es más fácil que se aprendan los irregulares porque los regulares son como 1800, ¿ok?
No.
Pero los regulares son más fáciles porque esos a veces, por lo que dice, a veces como que se parecen al español. Por ejemplo, facilitate, facilitar. ¿Ok? Provide, proveer. So they're easier. Son más fáciles, ¿ok? They're easier, ¿ok? Y no es que todos se usan también, ¿ok? Pero lo más recomendable es saber los irregulares, porque si no hay alguno en los irregulares, ¿qué es lo lógico? Si encuentro algún verbo que
sea irregular.
Irregular es lo lógico. Así que la lógica es saber los regulares, so not the regular ones, ¿ok? That's the logical, that's the logic. So, questions? No? Ok. Last activity for today. Última actividad hoy. Last activity for today. Now listen, on page number 30, We have activity number six. Tenemos esta actividad. We have activity number six, okay? So I will give you like 7 minutes, and in groups, you are going to complete this using should, could, would have, and a verb in past participle. And we have the example. If the servers have received proper training, they could have answered the customer's questions, okay? Si los meseros hubiesen recibido un entrenamiento apropiado o una capacitación apropiada, they could have answered the customer's questions, okay? Ellos podrían haber contestado las preguntas de los clientes, okay? Yeah? Okay, so we are going to complete the sentences y el verbo que está ahí, obviamente, this verb, ¿cómo lo van a poner? En presente.
Pasado participio.
Ah, in past participle, right? Lo van a poner en past participle, okay?
Past participle.
Yes. So let's complete the sentences. Do you have any question?
Teacher, only reminder, the tomorrow is the last day.
Oh, yes. Ya le voy a... Yes, that's right. Ajá, lo hice al principio, pero ya se lo voy a hacer al final, okay? Okay, so thank you, Miguel. Activity number six, page number 30. Okay? Vamos a trabajarlo en equipos. We are going to work in teams. Escriban solo las respuestas para que avancemos. Write only the answers to advance, okay? So, let's work in groups. Trabajemos en equipos entonces. Let's work in groups then. Okay.
Taken. Entonces, shouldn't have.
Should not taken, ¿verdad?
Ajá, porque está en negativo. Shouldn't have taken.
Number four.
Number
three. The servers
will have
been.
El be también es irregular.
Sí, been.
Been.
Sí.
Doble E y N al final.
Sí.
B-E-E-N. Mm-hmm. Be in trouble if they have been late for the meeting. By number four, you
ask
should have ask. Ese sí creo que es regular.
Es de verdad. Regular.
Yes, yes.
Ask it. Yo creo que es irregular.
Ask it.
Irregular. Ask it. Ask it. Number five. the cashier.
Y what are the dos?
Yes.
Taken
that money from the register. Taken. And finally, I show cold. Creo que es
regular. Es cold. Cold es regular.
Bueno, básicamente, cold, the manager, I was sick.
En el modelo primero, generalmente, esto es así, tenemos la opción de conectarnos ya sea a otro. Cold
es regular.
Es regular,
es regular.
Es regular.
Ok.
Finish.
La primera, hacia la segunda.
Cold es regular.
Okay, and the fine and the cashier shouldn't have
taken.
Okay, the three would have been.
The servers would have been.
Okay, the number two, the bartender shouldn't have taken. Okay. Yes. Only, yes.
Ninguna y vamos a usar el cool. No, ¿verdad?
No. No. Cool.
No, cool no. Only the first.
The first thing, I guess.
The service has to see.
Done. Ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. All right.
See, good night, teacher.
No, not yet. Not yet.
Good night.
Bueno, vamos a ir a
good night, teacher.
Media. No, finish. Good night. No, good night.
No, teacher. Podemos salirnos.
Yes, of course.
Okay. Para good night, teacher.
To say good night. To say good night. Para decir buenas noches. To say good night.
Ah, you said good night.
Okay. No, to say.
To say good night.
To say good night. Para decir buenas noches. To say good night. Yes.
Say good night, teacher.
¿Y qué tarea es la?
Okay, everyone. Just before we check, antes de revisar, just before we check, just one thing. Okay, solo algo importante. Just one important thing. Bueno, casi todos están conectados. Solo falta Sandra y ¿quién más dijimos? And who else? Y Zulma, ¿verdad?
Zulma.
Sandra y Zulma. Muy bien. El día de mañana. Ahí le hice el recordatorio al principio, pero mañana vamos a mañana termina la semana, bueno, la semana 3 sería la sección 3, perdón, mañana termina la sección 3. Eso indica de que para mañana, antes de la sesión, ustedes deben completar la sección 3 en la plataforma, ¿ok? Antes de la sesión, por favor no lo dejen para después de la sesión, porque si no me hacen que me desvele un poquito más a mí, ¿okay? para pasar los resultados. Así que, por favor, tratemos de tener lista la sección 3 antes de la sesión todos. ¿Ok? ¿De acuerdo?
Agree. De acuerdo. Ok,
teacher.
Agree, teacher.
Ok, and let's check the answers quickly. Ok, let's see. Adriana, what do you have in number one?
The bartender shouldn't have taken that bottle of wine without permission.
That's right. Shouldn't have taken, right? Or should not have taken. Thank you, Adriana. Number two, let's listen to, let me see here, to Gloria. The servers, number three, Gloria.
Okay. The servers would have been in trouble if they had been late for the meeting.
Good. So the answer is would have been, okay? Would have been, right? Would have been in trouble. Okay, thank you very much. Let's see number four. Osmin, you?
Yes, teacher. You should ask the manager for a day off.
Okay, hold on. Should ask or should have asked?
You should ask.
But yeah, but in the structure, en la estructura, dijimos que vamos a usar should have. Okay, have. Eso es parte de la estructura, should have. Y después va el verbo en past participle, okay? El verbo en pasado participle va después.
Right.
Yeah, repeat
you
this. The servers.
Yes, you have asked the manager for a day off.
That's right. So you should have asked, okay? Because it's regular, asked. You should have asked the manager for a day off, okay? Yes. Okay, let's see Susana, number five, the cashier.
Hi, the cashier shouldn't have taken that money from the register.
Good, shouldn't have taken or should not have taken. Thank you very much. Mayra, number six.
I should have called to let the manager I was sick.
Okay, thank you very much. So I should have called. Como call es regular, lo vamos a dejar así. Called, con ed. Okay? Y aquí hay un pequeño error. Aquí falta una palabra. Sería no. Okay? I should have called to let the manager know I was sick. Okay? Para hacerle saber que estaba enfermo. Okay? To let the manager know I was sick. Okay, everyone. Let's see, de los que estaban conectados rápidamente, bueno, Sandra no se conectó, right? She's not connected. Zulma tampoco se conectó, right? Yes? Los demás todos están. Yeah, okay. So thank you everyone for connecting today. Thank you very much. Only Jancy is going to stay, I think. Right, Jancy? Yes, right. Okay, thank you very much. Good night y completen la plataforma la sección 3 mañana antes de la sesión, ¿okay? Okay.
Okay, teacher. See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Good night. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Good night.
Bye.
Okay, Jancy, you look tired today. You look tired. Yes.
Tired.
Are you tired? A little bit.
Yes, I'm very tired. Is it being the mess?
Sorry?
Me está diciendo que siento cansada.
Yes, yes.
Sí. Es fin de mes y lo pienso de medio cruel.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Sí. Okay, Jancy, so this space is for you. If you have any questions, go ahead.
Necesito, si me puede retroalimentar, la parte de el uso del more y el more.
Okay. Yeah, it's okay. Okay.
Está en la página 28.
Ah, okay, good. Voy a hacerlo en la pizarra, creo que es mejor porque ahí voy en cada parte, así. Okay, so let's see. So first thing to know. Estudiamos primero el comparativo y el superlativo. El comparativo es cuando usamos more o la ER. What do you prefer? Comparativo. Okay, so we have two things. We have comparative. Obviously, como la palabra dice, la idea del comparative is to compare. La idea del comparativo es comparar.
Comparar.
Yes, okay. Y usamos algunas palabras que son clave. Por ejemplo, le ponemos er al adjetivo y aplicamos una regla como lo que estudiamos ayer, okay. También usamos el than. Esto es importante. This is very important, okay. Y para los adjetivos de dos o más sílabas usamos el more. Esto es para comparar. This is to compare. Ok. So now let's see one example. Veamos un ejemplo. Usando el adjetivo, por ejemplo, big. La regla que aplicamos acá para poner big, la R, es que le duplicamos la consonante porque decíamos que tenía consonante, vocal, consonante. Y era de una sílaba. Ok. Así que le duplicamos okay. La última consonante. Now let's see one example. You can say, for example, Mexico is, y aquí viene la parte importante, bigger. Bigger is más grande. And we use than, y usamos el than para hacer la comparación. Mexico is bigger than. México es más grande que El Salvador. Mexico is bigger than El Salvador. Okay? Now, I will use the verb intelligent. ¿Cuántas sílabas tiene intelligent? Intelligent. How many syllables?
Cuatro.
Four. Así que vamos a decir more. Okay? So I can say, for example, what? I will say Obama, right? I don't know. This is the only thing that comes to my mind. Okay? Obama is, aquí voy a usar el more. Ya no voy a usar la R, okay? Is more intelligent. Is more intelligent than. No voy a decir intelligent. More intelligent than. La misma estructura, solo que le pongo more en vez de la R. Porque es, tiene dos o más sílabas, okay? Is more intelligent than. Y puedo decir otro nombre. What? Any name, right? My brother, for example, okay? My brother. Obama is more intelligent than my brother. So, ¿a quién estoy comparando? A Obama y a mi hermano. En el primero que estoy comparando, México y El Salvador. So, esto es para comparar. This is to compare. Okay? Another example could be, for example, right? Vegetables, okay? Vegetables, vegetales, vegetables are better than pizza. Ok. Los vegetales son más, son mejores que la pizza. Vegetables are better than pizza. Talking about healthiness, right? Hablando de salud. Talking about health. Ok. Better than. Comparando. Dos personas, dos cosas o dos animales. Ok, eso es el comparative. ¿Estamos claros hasta ahí?
Sí. Sí, sí.
Vale, ahora vamos al otro tema, que es el que vimos ayer, fue, ¿verdad? The topic, ese se llama superlative. Y aquí la idea ya no es comparar. Aquí la idea es, ayer les daba esta palabra clave, to highlight, como resaltar una cualidad, to highlight a quality, ¿ok? That's the idea of the superlative. Y a diferencia del comparativo, aquí ya no vamos a usar er, en vez de er vamos a usar est, ¿ok? En vez de more, en vez de usar more, vamos a usar most. Y en vez de than, que decíamos than para comparar, vamos a usar de. Solo que el de se usa antes del adjetivo, ¿ok? ¿Ya? Yeah. La idea es resaltar una cualidad. To highlight a quality, ¿ok? Now let's see one example. What? I can say, for example, China. China is the country with y aquí voy a cambiar de color, aquí viene el superlativo. China is the country with the biggest, with the biggest population. ¿Ok? No sé si es verdad, creo que sí, me parece. ¿Ok? China es el país con la población más grande, the biggest. Está usando el de, se usa antes, big, y aquí voy a poner est en vez de er, ¿ok? Hay otro país, digamos, según mi ejemplo, no estoy seguro, pero hay otro país que tenga una mayor población, ninguno. China es el que tiene la población más grande, supongo, I suppose, or I don't know, yeah? But the idea is that, ¿ok? Esa es la idea, the idea is that, ¿ok?
Okay. Otro ejemplo utilizando.
Sorry?
Otro ejemplo utilizando most.
Igual, el most se va a usar cuando el adjetivo tiene dos o más sílabas, la misma regla del more. ¿Ok?
Uh-huh.
Yes? Okay,
ah, I sí, can say. La diferencia es que el more es comparativo y este es superlativo.
Ah, es para resaltar. Ok, vaya, puedo decir, por ejemplo. English is the, aquí viene el superlativo, the most spoken, dos sílabas, ¿verdad? Spoken, the most spoken language around the world. Around the world, ¿ok? El inglés es la lengua más hablada alrededor del mundo. ¿Hay otra lengua que se hable más que el inglés? Ninguna. Estoy resaltando una cualidad por sobre todo lo demás, ¿ok? So, is the most spoken. ¿Por qué digo the most? Porque el adjetivo spoken tiene más de dos, tiene dos sílabas, ¿ok?
Ok.
Ajá, solo que aquí debemos ver algo muy importante. Decía que si había una palabra, un adjetivo que terminaba con ye, aunque tenga dos sílabas, se va a quitar la ye y vamos a decir busiest, for example, ¿ok? Más ocupado, the busiest, ¿ok? Yeah. Y que hay algunos adjetivos que son irregulares, así como los verbos irregulares, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, en el caso de, okay, let me get the pen. En el caso de good, de bad y de far. ¿Ok? Por ejemplo, el comparativo de good es better. En el comparativo voy a usar better. Para bad, en el comparativo voy a usar worse. Para far voy a usar farther, for example. ¿Ok? Y en el superlativo voy a usar best para el good. Para el worst voy a usar worst. Y para el far voy a usar farthest. Estos cambian totalmente. No solo les pongo es o most o more, ¿ok? Cambian porque son adjetivos irregulares, ¿ok?
Ok.
¿Ya?
Sí. Sí.
Ok.
Está bien.
¿Alguna otra pregunta? ¿Any other question?
No, por el momento solo eso. Pero igual voy a buscar más información porque si me confundo.
Videos. Los videos, ¿ok? Porque ahí practico listening también. Videos en YouTube. Si gustas, te puedo mandar algunos videos. Solo me escribas un mensajito. Profe, mándeme los videos y te puedo compartir algunos, ¿ok?
Ok, me parece.
Ok, perfect. Ok, Jassy, thank you very much for connecting today.
Ok.
Ok.
Good night.
Sí. Take care. See you tomorrow.
Sí.
Ok, bye.